Here we're going to derive the equations for calculating the change in entropy for an ideal gas where we change temperature and or we change pressure. And where we want to start is with the definition of entropy. And that definition is that the change in entropy between two states is equal to the integral of the reversible heat transfer divided by the absolute temperature. So the idea is we're at state one, some pathway to state two. As long as that's a reversible pathway, we can calculate the entropy change between states one and two because entropy is a state function. Now to calculate the heat transfer, we're going to start with the first law and we're going to start in differential form, a closed system. So the change and internal energy of course is also a state function, reversible heat and reversible work. For an ideal gas, du is cv dt, doesn't matter the pathway, that's always true for an ideal gas. We're interested in dq reversible, and again if it's reversible we can write the work as minus p dv, where p is the pressure of the gas. So now I can rearrange this and turn equal to dq reversible. So there's the equation. So what I'm going to do is divide both sides by absolute temperature. And then if I put an integral sign for each of these terms, what I have is delta S is equal to this. If I assume Cv is constant, then this becomes the log of T2 over T1, because I'm integrating from T1 to T2. Now the second term, I'm going to have to apply the ideal gas law. And so pressure over temperature is equal to gas constant divided by the volume. And this is specific volume, so this is per mole. So I make that substitution, integral of R dv over v, and I can integrate the second term. So now I have an equation, allows me to calculate entropy change for an ideal gas between some starting volume and temperature and final volume and temperature. Well, I can rearrange this if I want to write it in terms of pressure and temperature by substituting into the term here, again using the ideal gas. So let me rewrite this and then make that substitution. So P1 V1 equals RT1 and P2 V2 equals RT2. So if I divide the second equation by the first, V2 P2 over P1 V1 equals T2 over T1, or V2 over V1 is pressure 1, temperature 2, pressure 2, temperature 1. I can substitute now for this term in the log term. So pressure initial, temperature final, P2, T1. Now remember, we have log of products. It's the sum of logs. So this second term, I can rewrite as log of P1 over P2 plus R log of T2 over T1. And notice we have a log term for T2 over T1 twice, so we can add those together. This term, Cv plus R, for an ideal gas, Cv plus R is equal to Cp. Write the final version of the equation for the entropy change for an ideal gas between starting temperature and pressure and final temperature and pressure. And this last term I'm going to invert so that the pressure 2 is on top, and from our knowledge of logs that means the log is a minus sign, so P2 over P1. And so now we have an equation for entropy change, ideal gas. And now, in terms of starting pressure and temperature, the other equation derived in terms of starting volume. And any pathway, we pick to calculate dq reversible, we end up with an equation that's just a function of initial and final conditions because entropy is a state function.